ideal legislative assembly speaker of all. If I may request to kindly come forward, and it is indeed my honor and privilege to read the proclamation of this award. The proclamation which would be presented says, Bharatiya Chhatra Sansad Foundation proclamation awarded Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan, Speaker of Kerala State Legislative Assembly. Sir, you as the Honorable Speaker of Kerala State Legislative Assembly have displayed outstanding commitment, courage, conviction, coupled with revolutionary ideas of clean governance and transparency in the legislative processes to take Kerala on the path of development. You have constantly engaged in youth-centric activities and contributed in improving the educational and other opportunities for the youth of Kerala. You are an epitome of honesty, integrity, and have retained your image, that of credible speaker who is widely respected and delivers on his promises of economic growth coupled with the social welfare. We also thank you for taking the efforts to address the delegates of Bharatiya Chhatra Sansad and share with them your profound life experiences and the values that you practiced, which have earned you the recognition and eminence in society. Signed, Raghunath A. Mashelkar, President, BCS. Signed, Vishwanath D. Karar, Executive President, BCS, Founder President, MIT World Peace University. Signed, Tushar Gandhi, Executive Chairman, BCS, President of Mahatma Gandhi Foundation. And signed, Rahul V. Karad, Founder, Bharatiya Chhatra Sansad, Chief Initiator and Dean of MIT School of Government. Let's once again give a big, big, big round of applause to Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan Ji, Honorable Speaker of Kerala State Legislative Assembly. With the special request, I would take 2 more minutes and request my technical team if you can please relay a small film made on the life and work of Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan Ji.
Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan, Honorable Speaker of the Kerala Legislative Assembly, represents the constituency of Ponani in Malappuram district in North Kerala. He has envisaged and executed several novel and unique activities which helped improve public awareness and positive involvement in Kerala governance considerably. He initiated codifying a set of rules to determine the practice and procedure of the Kerala Legislative Assembly along the lines of the practice and procedure of Parliament by call and shudder. Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan initiated a study to assess the impact of laws passed by the Kerala Legislative Assembly. The study was the first of its kind in the history of Indian legislature. He was instrumental in introducing the landmark decision to solicit citizens' suggestions and opinions on draft bills notified online. Under his leadership, the Centre for Parliamentary Studies and Training, CPST of Kerala Legislative, expanded its activity with major thrust on constitutional studies and youth outreach programs. As part of the Diamond Jubilee celebrations of the first Kerala Legislative Assembly, Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan introduced Festival on Democracy, a thematic concept that envisaged national level conferences aimed at strengthening and fostering the power and scope of democracy. The national conference under Festival on Democracy was a national legislators' conference on the challenges in the empowerment of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in independent India. The second edition, the National Students Parliament, had phenomenal participation of more than 2,500 youth from all over the country as well as a few from foreign countries. In 2020, Shri P. Sri Ramakrishnan introduced E-Niyama Sabha, aimed at a paperless legislative assembly to ease the legislative processes. Sri P. Sri Ramakrishnan was actively involved in the conceptualization and conduct of Loka Kerala Sabha, an event organized by the state that brings global Keralites under one platform to invoke their collective wisdom for the progress and welfare of the state. Kerala Legislature has soft launched Sabha TV, an OTT channel, the first of its kind for any of the state legislatures in India, on the lines of Rajya Sabha TV. Arivoram, an official newsletter of the Kerala Legislative Assembly, was also launched under his leadership. In tow with the green protocol adopted by the government, Sri Ramakrishnan started Project Kadilivanam, organic farming of 32 different plantain varieties in the backyard of the assembly building. He also initiated paddy cultivation, vegetable farming, Tulasivanam with wide varieties of basil plants and rose garden with hundreds of different kinds of roses in the premises. Thumbur Muri model dry compositing project has been in operation to take care of organic waste management of the assembly complex. Imagination, commitment to democratic values and principle of transparency and readiness to innovate displayed by this man is taking the Kerala Assembly to newer heights of esteem in the national political landscape.
Let's give a big round of applause for the vision and mission Sri P. Sri Ramakrishnan is taken. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your presence. Thank you very much for that film.
Adarniye P. Sri Ramakrishnan ji, dais tak chalkar aaye, mic tak chalkar aaye, aur aap zordar taaliyon ke saath unke udbodhan ke liye unka swagat karein. Adarniye Sri P. Ramakrishnan ji.
Respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, and my dear friends, sisters and brothers, I feel honored, privileged and humbled to stand before you today and be felicitated by the Honorable Vice President of India on behalf of an institution that has raised the bar of standards for even the highest standards of learning in all of India. It is very proud to be here on the occasion of Bharatiya Chhatra Parishad, 10th Bharatiya Chhatra Parishad, which is the vast reservoir of ideas to irrigate the democratic process, democratic political landscape of our country. Ever since the conception and fruition of the first BCS, MIT, World Peace University has come a long way in innovation, creativity and persistence of purpose in holding this event successfully year after year, and now bringing the spectacle to the national capital for a crowning glory of double digits, this being the 10th of its kind. Let me at the outset congratulate those who are assembled here, also the man who is behind the initiative, no other than Mr. Rahul Karat, my close friend and brother. I don't have any hesitation to reveal one thing here. When I was selected as a speaker of a legislative assembly, some press people asked me, how you manage the house? Because some veterans are sitting here, those who came to the house before your birth. How you manage this? I was simply replied them. Democracy is a system to hear the voice of even a small kid in such a way I can manage. Though I have replied there, really I don't know clear clarity. After that, I got an opportunity to have an interaction with the students and Bharatiya Chhatra Parishad in Pune. Mr. Rahul compelled me and invited me to have a speech there. I can tell you, after that experience, it was the biggest, richest, precious inspiration which I had in my political life. From that, I thought, how we can remodel the process of democracy? How we can blend the creativity of our own thoughts to the process of democracy? Really, I can say you, because of that experience, I tried to remodel the system of democracy as can as possible. As we all know, the nation is passing now through very significant and trying times we have known since independence. Ever since the idea of India reverberated in the pages of this nation's great constitution, our mentality is too slowly but surely transformed from one that was weighed down by the horrors of colonialism and apartheid to one that of immense pride and eternal hope. I used to tell some examples which I had in my life. I think in my last speech also I tried to explain it. When I got an opportunity to attend an international youth leadership camp in Latin America, we were 14 youth representatives from 14 parties were attending in that camp. It was a 15 days long camp. The second day, the majority of the camp attendees could understand we are not using talking each other in same language. At the time of campfire, they asked, what is your mother tongue? Then I told Malayalam, next Tamil, next Gujarati, Oriya. 14 delegates have 14 languages. Then they asked, we came from South America, from nine countries. We used to talk each other in Spanish. You don't have even a language to talk each other. Then how can you have a nation? We didn't expect that question. But we stood up and totally, all of you are answered, that is India. That is India. Unity without uniformity. Diversity without fragmentation. That is India. We have to uphold the idea of India. Our constitution formulated from the basement of this field. It is not only some rules to rule. It has some inherent values. It has some inherent values. We have to uphold the constitution and its values. I'm seeing you. And that has been the nation we have been serving there, and those have been the guiding principles we have been protecting ever since. And this, my dear friends, I feel is a time as good as any to reflect, rediscover, reaffirm, and reassert our faith in the fundamental values and concepts etched in our constitution, and to perceive the grave threats looming large in today's times of divisiveness, intolerance, and the resulting chaos. Let me quote one book. It's a famous book, The Narrow Corridor to Liberty. It was written by the renowned authors, Sharon Agmelu and Robinson. It was a series of how, why nation fails. That book is in that series. The others were researching how we can attain the liberty. Liberty is a word which is little bigger than freedom. It's a noun form of liberation. They were researching, some civilizations enjoying the liberty, used to enjoy the liberty, but some civilization always losing it. why it's happening. It was a great research. In that research and book, they are trying to explain. There should be an interaction between civil society and state. If the state is strong, civil society also to be strengthened. Otherwise, there will be a chance of autocracy. It will lead to dictatorship. At the same time, if the civil society is strong, state is weak, then the anarchy will come. So it should be interact each other. You have to strengthen your civil society if you need to strengthen the democracy. How we can strengthen the civil society? It's a question. If you need to strengthen the civil society, you have to strengthen your democracy. Democracy is not a phenomena to start in a day, to end in a day. I think it's a flow of life. It's a focus of our life. It's a flow of feel. It should be the future of our mankind. In such a way, you have to approach democracy. Democracy has to be revamped, has to be redefined. How we can revamp democracy? It is not only a question of vote, casting your votes. It's a flow of feel. If you want to revamp the democracy, you should bring transparency, involvement to the process of political system. That is why we are trying a lot of experiences. Normally, in a legislative assembly, only a legislature can submit the amendments of the bill, on the bill. But we in Kerala Assembly decided any layman can, any common man can submit his amendments to the office of the speaker. It will be collected and will be given to the concerned minister. We adopted one law, for example, clinical establishment bill. We got 1,562 amendments from the common people. That amendments considered by the minister, and the minister accepted 421 amendments. Another thing, I'm not taking more time to explain my experiences. We decided to start 1,000 constitutional classes for the students. As far as our democracy festival on democracy is concerned, we discuss a lot whether it is festival of democracy or festival on democracy. Finally, we concluded it should be festival on democracy. On democracy means you have to dream how democracy can improve in every day. It has to be revamped. And not taking more time, democracy is our way of life. It's a magical system of governance, utterly craved by those who are denied and devoid it. Democracy is also a system snubbed and maligned by many who are lucky to have it, but who use, misuse, and abuse it. If democracy is sometimes perceived a malady, it also becomes its only remedy. I would like to tell you, you have to join to the political scenario, political landscape of our country. It is not necessary to have with a political party. You should have political understanding. You should have an idea of India. Idea of India is different. It is an exhibition of symbiosis. It should be an exhibition of symbiosis, cultural symbiosis. That symbiosis formulated in our constitution. I would like to congratulate Mr. Rahul Karat for his hard work to improve the democratic process in our country. I will call him. I will call him the informal ambassador of our democratic process in our country. Informal ambassador of our democratic process. Because I am remembering how he was intervening in the activities of our legislative assembly. Though he don't have any responsibility there, he came two or three times to help us. He sent his team. And what we have a dream that became reality because of the help of his team and MIT Pune. That's why I am not taking more time. Once again, I would like to express my thankfulness, my gratitude to you all and give me a chance to be here, and also thank you for the organizers which you are organizing this type of Bharatiya Chhatra Parishad for the last 10th years. Thank you all.